Guardian Radio, your station for up-to-the-minute news, intelligent, interactive, and engaging conversation. 96.9 FM. The views and opinions of the hosts and guests are their own and do not necessarily reflect the position of the management and staff of Guardian Network.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours. It will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes, glory is destined. Everyday women and men become legends. Sins that go against our skin become blessings. The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice is juxtapositioning us. Justice for all just ain't specific enough. One son died, his spirit is revisiting us. True and living, living in us. Resistance is us. That's why Rosa sat on the bus. That's why we walked through Ferguson with our hands up. When it go down, we woman and man up. They say stay down, and we stand up. Shots, we on the ground. The camera panned up. King pointed to the mountaintop, and we ran up.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh.
Good morning. Welcome to Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. You know my voice already. It's Leyvon Miller. Thank you so much for letting me join you. Thank you so much for joining me. I don't know what it is that you do at 11 o'clock, but whatever it is you do, I'm happy that you do that, do with me. It's an open line. I've only got one, so you all play nicely. Try to keep the calls as succinct as possible. I'm asking some questions this morning, but before we get to that, I want to keel over and roll and rub my belly as I laugh about this nonsense on the front page this morning by the Minister of Disaster Preparedness and Reconstruction. And I'm going to read it for you in its entirety because I want you all to see the silliness that we call governance in the Bahamas, right? I thought it was asinine to begin with to move in the direction of the purchase of domes, particularly after the storm. And I want to do a show. I'm actually trying to put it together for you guys. I want to do a show on whether or not the Bahamas has failed at the management of the temporary housing that we have already created. What many of you may not or may be aware of is that in the Bahamas, during the Pinling era, the government of the Bahamas undertook to construct several pieces of properties or construct on several pieces of property temporary housing. All or the majority of it in New Providence, but notwithstanding, temporary housing. And what we've permitted over the past, God knows how long, is for these temporary houses to turn into pieces of real estate that people now pass on like generation property, right? It's something I'm looking into and I'm working on. Apparently, you need to go through many agencies to figure out who is responsible for what around you. But in almost every instance, particularly in the inner city of New Providence, where you see the buildings are painted pink and green, I am advised that those are all owned by the government. And those were actually constructed for the purpose of low rental temporary housing. All right? We have failed at that. And that is why we have to continue to do things like this silly nonsense on the front page this morning. I decry it, right? Like you cannot just fritter away $6 million. You cannot just fritter away the people's money and act as though we ought not be upset about it. And I get it. $6 million in the grand scheme of things, as many economists will say, is no great, great amount of money for a government. As a matter of fact, I would even say on many occasions that if you understand the way government works, $6 million is no money at all, right? What is also factual, though, is that these are very interesting times in the world. And for the last 3 years, we haven't lived in a world that wasn't saddled with interesting times. All right, so I want to read it. It says, government considering scrapping plan to erect more domes. You remember the whole field trip the prime minister and his whole entourage did in Abaco? You remember the field trip of the prime minister, the director of NEMA, and whomsoever else will down there at Gladstone Road when they put on display the way the igloo thingies would work? I'm here to report to you that dismally, they've failed at it, and now they're thinking about scrapping the idea. The paper reported in the Nassau Guardian this morning by Rachel Scott has the story, and it says this: with 100 domes still awaiting erection on Abaco and Grand Bahama, 21 months after Hurricane Dorian, Minister of Disaster Preparedness, Management and Reconstruction, Pekisha Barker-Edgecombe, said yesterday the government is considering whether those domes should still be erected, noting that they were meant for temporary solution in the more immediate aftermath of the storm. There has been concern expressed about the delay in having them erected, but again, funding has always been an issue for us, Barker-Edgecombe told reporters outside cabinet. We are giving it our best. We are trying to help, but the question now is, and the story then kind of goes over to page A10, whether or not those domes still need to be put up, because it was supposed to be temporary. So it's all of this that is going on at the moment. We're trying to get to the best practice to assist those residents in Abaco, in particular, because housing is an issue, which is funny because the government admits through its cabinet minister that housing, this is in the article, this is Leyvon, admits through the cabinet via its minister that there is a housing crisis in Abaco while simultaneously pushing down houses, right? Let's continue. We're trying to get the best practice to assist those residents in Abaco in particular because housing is an issue. We are also appealing to the private sector individuals who may want to go to Abaco to build rental units to do this. As you know, the DRA, the Disaster Reconstruction Authority, is now in the works with trying to introduce a 100-unit rental specifically for our government workers in that area, too, because several services are also very integral to the development of Abaco. But yes, we are having challenges, and we expect it. But that does not necessarily mean that we are not going to continue to commit ourselves to our promises. We are going to ensure that those residents get the attention they deserve. Hurricane Dorian, a Category 5 storm, decimated portions of Abaco and Grand Bahama in September of 2019. Following the storm, Prime Minister Dr. Hubert Minnis announced the establishment of temporary housing in the form of dome-like structures, which was expected to cost $6.4 million. He said the government planned to set up 250 domes in Abaco in a tent city. However, many Dorian survivors have raised concerns over the pace with which the government has moved to implement its plans for housing assistance. Abaco residents have also been questioning when a new community center and hurricane shelter in central Abaco, which the government broke ground on in December, will be completed. At the time, Minnis said the facility will be finished in May of 2021 ahead of the hurricane season. However, Barker-Edgecombe said it is now hoped that it will be completed by the end of this summer. We are hoping that, we are hoping that is done, that it is done very shortly. She said, I know that there is a concern in Abaco also with regards to some other housing issues. So what we're doing is we're sitting at the table still. We're trying to figure out how best to move forward. Our funding has always been an issue for us, but we are now very grateful for the fact that the persons are now coming on board to assist us with that. I am hopeful in all honesty that it is completed before the end of the summer, because the reality is we would have wanted it to be done well before the hurricane season, but we are going to continue to work towards having it completed. Can anybody tell me, you can raise your hands if you'd like, what is the plan other than to hope and pray? Is any member of the cabinet going to be able to tell me what is the direct direction for the temporary housing? Can anybody tell me whether or not we're going to work that plan in tandem with the reconstruction plan, or are we going to still put these little igloos on the little wooden surface for the hurricane to just blow them away? Because I'm not really sure if I heard a plan coming out of that. How are you 20 odd months after the storm looking at what is the best practice? How are you months after the storm, months after breaking ground, months or a month at least after missing your deadline, still not certain when you will have the hurricane shelter erected? Are we not in hurricane season? You see, when people say that this government struggles with incompetence, right? I think that they're being kind to them. I think that this government is not incompetent at all. I think that they are inept and they suffer from ineptitude assessment or ineptitude in their execution. That is what I'm looking to say. Incompetence would suggest that they do not know. Ineptness means that they do not even possess the ability to know. And that is what it sounds like to me. Anyway, that's not what I came here to talk about this morning. My line is 325-4259. I'll give it to you again, 325-4259. Inept. That is. Oh my goodness. This thing made me want to cry as I read it this morning. We are hoping, we are praying. Y'all might as well turn that into the cabinet, Greater Cabinet Church of God. No, please don't let it be a Church of God in Christ. Greater Cabinet Missionary Baptist Church. Yeah, let's go with that. Because if all I get out of the cabinet is we can pray and we can hope, then I want to stop some of these salaries. I want to stop some of these salaries. Anyway, so I'll tell you what else I'm talking about. You can text me, 422-4796. You could call me, 325-4259. I've got three questions, right? I was in the inner city yesterday because that's where I like to be. And I think my PLP friends are mildly delusional, right? Outside of the fact that this FNM government can't stop tripping down all over itself, I still don't believe that the people of the Commonwealth of the Bahamas have become so disenchanted with their fondness of the Free National Movement in 2017 or at whatever other time, that they are prepared to just divorce themselves of the Free National Movement and go back to the FNM, I mean to the PLP, sorry. And so I hear PLPs suggesting a landslide. And no matter how I flip the cards over, I do not see a landslide. And so I thought this morning I would come and ask the general public, right? Because I want to know what it is that you think. I don't want to continue walking around in my own echo chamber. But I want to know, in this upcoming election, which seats do you imagine will be the deciding seats? I've got a couple. I'll let you know what they are. And I also want to know, which of the seats do you think will be the hottest races to watch? I've got a couple, I'm going to tell you what they are. But more importantly, what I think I want us to all agree on, call, I see you, I'm on my way. What I want us to agree on here and now, we can have kind of like a subtle verbal contract between yourself, myself, and the rest, and the people that are listening. Who are some of the people we want to see back in the parliament, regardless of what the outcome is? Is there any among them? And you saw the spiel by Fort Charlotte MP, what's his name? Mark Humes. Who, if you Googled Mark Humes, you would see Mark Humes himself said he never wanted to be a politician. And that if someone told him he was going to be a politician, he would laugh them away. You can Google Mark Humes resigns as chairman of the Democratic National Alliance. And, you know, I think it was Clifford Scavala that said this. I don't want to falsely accuse him. Never let a man be in charge of anything that no one thought could be in charge of it. Never, ever let the guy no one thought would be in charge be in charge. Very simple, right? So Mark Humes is leaving, and you saw the wonderful farewell speech. I wanted to throw confetti in the air for him. But I don't know. Maybe people would prefer to live their lives without seeing him back in the House of Assembly. But is there somebody either elected now or on the campaign trail now, whom you wish that no matter how the cookie crumbles, whether it is a PLP administration or an FNM administration, or even if by some chance there is a coalition of some sort that takes place inside the parliament, by whatever machinations it takes place, who are some of the names and the persons that you want to make sure when the smoke is settled and the dust is cleared, or when the dust is settled and the smoke is cleared on election day, their president accounted for. Let's take the call online. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Hey, morning, Leyvon. What's up, Mr. Miller?
Hey, Duet.
All is well?
Mm-hmm.
Boy, let me ask you, you know, I don't, I mean, it's something that you raised a point a little earlier.
Mm-hmm.
You know, Mr. Miller, let's be realistic now. Let's put the politics aside and let's talk like men, mm-hmm. okay? How long has the hurricane hit Grand Bahama and Abaco?
Too long ago.
Okay? And I mean, Mr. Miller, I could, if you want me right now, as I speak to you, I can send you photos that people are still living in tents, bro.
I know.
In tents. T-E-N-T-S, tents. And you mean to tell me the minister, the Miss Parker, coming to tell the people, you know, you go up, these people just go up there, you know, Mr. Miller. I told him one day where someone took a photo that when the FNM was campaigning in East Grand Bahama, they was going to the place into the tent to talk to them.
Mm-hmm.
Someone sent me the photo.
Mm-hmm.
How could this be from 2 years later, bro? What could you do what you ain't do 2 years later now? Just because it's coming towards election? But I want to say this to you, Mr. Miller, and I can say this to the Bahamian people. I pray to God that the PLP finds money, right, after they deal with the people needs, find money to have a commission inquiry on this government. And I don't want to say certain things, because you know you can't say certain things on the radio, Mr. Miller. And also have an international commission inquiry on this government, because, Mr. Miller, let me tell you something, my brother. You might sit behind that microphone every day of your life. You might find out things, but if you really know the in-depth of what's going on in this country, you might break off running, bro.
Mm.
Have a good day, my brother.
Appreciate you, DeWitt. 325-4259. You know, I thought we failed on so many levels in Abaco. I think to castigate the two former prime ministers the way we did was a failure on our behalf. I believe that Mr. Ingram could have gone into Abaco and masterfully, to steal a word from Desmond Bannister, handled the situation on the ground down there. I think that he would have been a wonderful tool to have in the toolbox, right? And we missed that opportunity. I also believe that Hurricane Dorian should have been possibly the single most galvanizing incident in this country since the independence, the flamingo, or what was the other thing that galvanized all Bahamians. Anyway, the point I'm making is they are now asking for private developers and that kind of stuff to come in and build rental units. I think there should have been a national call to redevelopment in Abaco, where the government somehow guaranteed that, listen, if you have equipment, if you have building experience, if you have whatever it is that you have, we are taking our talents to Abaco and we will rebuild it in 1 year. There should have been a flotilla of talent moving in the direction of Abaco, secured by a government guarantee, and we figure out how or when or what would our Abaco look like 1 year later. But and you could say, oh, well, do you know what that would have cost the government? No, I have no clue. But what I know is we, you know, the government sits here and fritters away $6.4 million. And the only thing they can give me for $6.4 million is they're going to check best practices, we hope, and we pray. And I don't believe governance is to be ran off of hope and prayers. And I really like praying. Let's take another call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Yeah. Mr. Miller.
Hey, buddy.
On top of all of that, what you just said, do you know their argument is that they are saving lives? They're building lives.
How?
Exactly how? And who you think you're talking to? Who you think you are gonna hoodwink this time? I listened to the first line.
Mm-hmm.
You said that you was better than them fellas. You was the right man.
They did say
okay?
that.
But here it is. A hurricane came. Okay, and you even didn't collect the money right.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you didn't galvanize the talent.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, and I saw there are a lot of workmen that are looking for work, and you ain't galvanized them to come to Abaco to help you.
And I think that's what should have happened. There should have been a national call to help for Abaco. Listen, the government of the Bahamas is booking 4 barges. We will have those barges in Abaco, you know, 4 or 5 days after the storm. If you are a person with any skill in building and architecture,
we need to take the
talent to Abaco. That's what should have happened.
Yes, but here you want to go on an emotional wave to switch the subject to immigration and go down there with a tractor and stuff like that to this last minute to win us over to think you running out the illegal immigrants and
but
all that.
But can't get right. Even that they can't seem to get right.
No.
I'll tell you why.
Okay.
Because there is no way.
Leyvon, mm-hmm. they need to go.
Yeah.
I mean, go in Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Thanks for letting me share.
My grandmother used to say, boy, not for my sake, son, for Christ's sake. Appreciate you for calling. No, and I'll tell you this, right? And I don't want to, you know, be labeled anti-FNM. I continue to tell you all, I's a I for Tanya FNM. If you ain't got 20 years as a FNM supporter, you can't even talk to me, right? Because I have believed in the philosophy for 20 years. So, you know, but they botched that, right? Even in this instance now where they're bulldozing houses, they can't seem to get that right. They've offended the court, all right? And on top of that, what is even worse is now there is a pronouncement by your minister from your cabinet suggesting that there is a housing crisis. Well, Jesus Christ. And that's the same thing the people from the UN said, that there was a housing crisis, and that's why you shouldn't be pushing the house them down. Oh, boy. Let's take another one. Good morning, Collie. Ron. Collie, you there? Let's try it again. Collie, you there?
Morning, Mr. Bader, how are you?
I feel great.
You said it's an open line, right?
Yeah, I actually had some questions. I don't know. Did you hear any of my questions?
No, yeah.
Go on, though. When I say open line, what I mean is I don't have a guest that you can call me. We can talk.
Right. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Let me share what's on my mind this morning. Mm-hmm. I have a word for the peace officers. You all are God's servants to restore law and order. Also, you are my brothers and sisters. Before you protect us, you must protect yourself first. The word of God justify you. Police officers will not kill a man if he is unarmed, if not be justified. Mm-hmm. The criminals who want to live, they will not challenge the police officers. Thank you, Mr. Have a blessed and safe day.
Thank you very much.
All right.
I see somebody here is, I don't know, maybe I'm rubbing them the wrong way. It says, Mr. Miller, you talk too much and don't like to read your listener's message. Only Haitians in Abaco, and they want something for nothing. So shut up. I need the FNM or PLP. Well, there. See, I just read your message. Let's take another call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there?
Yeah, go ahead. How you doing, man?
I good. How are you?
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Well, I think what the nation should do at this time, doing that the Haitian build quicker than them, so they need to hire them to build the domes, so that could be the best thing for them to do.
Well, I mean, again, I my whole deal is, you can't just act like this ain't $6 million you all spend. That's the point I make. When you go to spend $6 million, I imagine you have a plan. Like, you cannot just spend the money and then don't have a plan and come back and tell me what you pray and hope for. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, boy, Leyvon, I don't know. I don't know what someone said the other day, but you made a powerful point that I don't know where they're going, I don't know where they come from, and I don't know what we can do, but they got to go.
Well, not for my sake, for Christ's sake.
All
right, appreciate you. Let's take another call. We got another one? No, 325-4259. I asked some questions. Y'all can feel free to answer my questions. Let me ask them again just in case we've been sidetracked. And if I have sidetracked you all, I want to apologize because, you know, I had to read that story. Somebody here is asking me, this is completely off topic, but are we load shedding again? My power goes off daily for 2 hours, morning like 3 a.m. to 5 a.m. and evening like 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. Man, they can't be load shedding. Then the people say they buy all kind of brand new generator, load shed what? Not them. Impossible. It cannot be happening, right? So the questions I had asked were, what are going to be some of the most hotly contested seats in Nassau? What do you think are going to be the seats worth watching? That's what I want to know. Like, I believe the seats worth watching are going to be St. Barnabas. I think that is one that's going to be worth the watch. I think both, and this is interesting, I think both the seats in Andros are going to be worth the watch. Believe it or not, I believe North Abaco is going to be worth the watch, but let me tell you why. I am trying to see if the commander can even hold on down there. I believe when the wind blows through North Abaco, it's going to be rough sailing for my mentor, the Honorable Darren Enfield. I think it's going to be a rough time for him down there. So I think that's worth the watch. What else do I think is worth the watch around here? I think Pinewood Gardens has just had a switch in momentum in the benefit of the Free National Movement. Now, I'll tell you what I predicted. If my memory serves me correctly, originally they had budgeted $6 million for the flooding issue in Pinewood Gardens. Well, the government has allocated, I think, $2 million this time, which is one third of the money. I don't assume they will get that off the ground or completed, because I don't understand how you budgeted $6 million originally and then came back and was able to do it for $2 million, because they're going to share it between constituencies. And what that therefore means to me is that the project would probably be only one quarter of the way in its progression by the time his election is called. And hopefully, if the people see the work, they may say, boy, thank you, Jesus, Reuben Raman finally come. You know, he tall and he's wear this funny hat, but we like him because he get rid of the water, and they may re-elect him. So, I don't know. Maybe that momentum may turn out that way, or maybe it may not. But I think that the allocation of the money for the flooding issue in Pinewood Gardens has just given some steam to the FNM candidate down there. That is what I believe. And I also believe that, as much as I want to bite a hole in my tongue when I say it, that Renwood Wells' seat in Bamboo Town may not go anywhere either. Let's take another call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there? Okay, let's read a couple of these text messages. Someone here says, Leyvon, sadly, I've come to realize, speaking with many in the public, there is no question you are widely regarded only as a PLP troll. Well, don't talk to those people anymore, because obviously they are scatterbrained. They lack sense, actually. And if you listen to nonsense from people who have no sense, then you may be on a dangerous trajectory. Tall Pines might see our only independent candidate. What independent candidate? There's an independent candidate running Tall Pines. I think Tall Pines looks good for Mr. Dawn Sanders. I don't think it'll be worth the watch. I think it's literally going to be like watching gray paint dry. I don't imagine there's anything fancy to watch in Tall Pines. Let's take this call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Is there something happening with this phone line? Caller, you there?
Morning, Leyvon. How you doing?
Hey, Antoine.
I want to disagree with you on that point, but I believe that had the allocation been done during year one, then the people of Pinewood would appreciate that. Yes, these people out care for us, but they dragged the people along for 4 years of governance, and in the last year they allocate a portion of the monies or a portion of the payment required in order to get the works done. And so, in essence, all you're doing is telling people, you don't value them. You only care about them in an election year. And the Bahamian people have a history of seeing past that. And so the Bahamian people will take what you have to offer, but they will still vote you out.
You disagreed with me, but I think you... sorry, you disagreed with me, but I think you hear what I say, you know. What I said was, when I consider the allocation of the money, see, I want you to listen to me. The allocation of the money, in my estimation, comes at a perfect time. Why? Because it was originally suggested that the flooding issue in Pinewood Garden would take about $6 million to fix. Well, if they've only gotten one-third of the money and they only were prepared to spend one-third of the money, that means that they are prepared for the project to not be completed, right? If they started the project in year one or year two with that allocation, you just see they waste $6 million in Abaco. There's no saying that they would have found more money to complete the project. So you may have had a project that had stalled. And that would have been worse than for them to, in the last year, carry $2 million into Pinewood. What people will see is the project beginning, the digging up of the road, the drilling of the wells, the putting in of the gutters. I understand that they have to run canals in Pinewood, etc. So when people see that, with such a short time left to go, you won't run out of money before the time comes.
Let me ask you, Leyvon, you really believe that the Bahamian people will be fooled in an election year when 4 years have gone by and you didn't do anything for the people?
Which administration hasn't tried it?
Either way, I'd like to answer the question that you asked as it relates to the seat to watch in this country.
Sure.
The seat that I'm watching, Leyvon, I'm hopeful that the good people of the constituency of Kalani runs the prime minister or their constituency as the member of parliament and certainly rolls him out as the prime minister in this country.
I think you're very wishful, Antoine. As a matter of fact, if I didn't know any better, I would almost think that you took a chemical substance. If you don't know anything about this race, what you will hear is that even the people that do not agree with the prime minister's politics agree that he's been a pretty decent member of parliament. So unless there's a chemical imbalance happening in your mind right now, I don't foresee Kalani going with the PLP. That is beyond wishful. It is fanciful, actually. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there? 3254259. Good morning, caller. You're on. Are you going to talk to me or are you going to listen to the radio? Good morning, caller. You're on.
I'm trying to get the Leyvon Miller show. I actually got disconnected.
You're very live. This is Leyvon Miller, my dear.
Oh, hi.
How are you?
One second.
Is she still there?
Mr. Miller.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I feel like I'm in the best shape of my life. How are you?
Good. Listen, I call concerning the... I call concern the family would die, would have a crazy young man died yesterday by the shooting of the policeman.
Mm-hmm. No, the police shooting. Turn your radio down. Talk to me in the phone.
Turn radio down. Hello.
Yeah.
Yeah. 35 years ago, my brother died. By the hands of the policeman.
Okay.
They shot him in Cloud Road.
Mm-hmm.
He was going crazy too. But I think the police should have not used the gun to shoot the young man, but they shoot him five times or several times.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
He shoot him several times.
You mean the young man
yesterday? I think we should use some precaution,
mm-hmm.
Taser, some precaution to get rid of this.
Okay, I think she's having a difficulty with that phone, Ali. If she calls back, let me know. 3254259, 422-4796 is my text line. Let me get a couple of these text messages out of the way. This year says, morning, Leyvon, the FNM will win the same amount of seats the PLP won in the last general election. St. Anne's, Kalani, Long Island, North Eleuthera, they are FNM safe seats. That's what you believe? Four seats? I have them counted a bit higher than that. Like I don't think the FNM will lose their St. Barnabas seat. I think that Michael Halkidis is in for the fight of his life down there in St. Barnabas. I don't care if he lived there till he was 12 or 13. I think he's in for the fight of his life in St. Barnabas. I also believe that Carmichael Road, again, will be not a race to watch. No one will care. Although we know predominantly it is one of the major seats. I don't think Mr. Keith Belt and Desmond Bannister kind of, you know, create enough energy for people to want to watch. Also, what else I think is going to be a very hotly contested seat? I don't think Tall Pines is anything to watch. I believe Dawn Sanders may be able to scrape that one away. I think the people wanted the pot cake, and since we didn't give them the pot cake, I'm not sure what they will do. And so, you know, I'm anxious when we get to places like North Eleuthera and South Eleuthera, because I believe that those may also get away. Those may get away from the FNM. Let's take a call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Yeah, Mr. Miller.
Hey, how you doing?
You are very wrong with your enthusiasm about St. Barnabas.
Okay.
St. Barnabas, yes, has got a good MP.
Mm-hmm.
But there are lots of folks here that does not want that FNM back in office.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? The MP is excellent, fine.
Mm-hmm.
But the leader...
So he's going to be a victim of the wave?
...for that leader. Okay? So, mm-hmm. Mr. Halkidis, man, look here. He is on this ground, and there are people that is wishing him well, and their last time was red shirt.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? But man, look here. This St. Barnabas is pure yellow.
So let me ask you a question. Don't run just yet. Because I asked this question, right? That no matter what happens, there are some faces that I want to see in the parliament. Shannon Onkardright happens to be one of them. Are you saying to me that we would risk losing a good face like a Shannon Onkardright just to get rid of the FNM? Is that your position?
Yes, sir. Okay? It might sound stupid to you. But trust me, a lot of stupid things happening. Stupid things happening. And sometimes it's good to do some stupid stuff to get rid of some wrong people who we made a mistake with.
So Baby and Badwater must go.
Well, We're looking for a brighter future.
No problem.
And Mr. Minister is not a part of it, sir.
Right.
Okay, he costs us too much money, man. Okay?
I take your word for it. Thank you very much. 325-4259. You can give me a call. You can text me, 422-4796. This says, what happened again? Is this guy, Anthony, violating more civil rights than our FNM? Don't you all ever want to be free? All the FNM does is refer to the past record of the PLP, full of excuses. What a burst of fresh wind, this Queen Simone. Oh, that's not for me. Okay, that's my music. I'm going to a break. Don't move. Leyvon Miller, I'm unleashed on your radio. We'll be back.
Glory, oh, glory, glory.
Hands to the heavens, no man, no weapon formed against, yes.
In life, there are always challenges. Today, we find ourselves having to be more self-sufficient, socially aware, and technically savvy. At J.S. Johnson, we are committed to our customers by providing cost-effective insurance solutions. No matter what your insurance needs, we will always be here for you. Call 397-2100 or visit jsjohnson.com. J.S. Johnson Insurance Agents and Brokers, giving you peace of mind.
There comes a time when the game tolerates no spectators, only players. There comes a time when we must recognize that our individual aspirations shape our collective destiny. There comes a time when getting in the game, despite the risks, despite the challenges, regardless of the cost, is simply the right thing to do. There comes a time when we must find our hearts, find our soul, and pursue our purpose for the greater good of all, for country, for humanity. There comes a time when we must manifest our true greatness. Yes? There comes a time, and that time is now. So let's get down to the essentials. The essentials. Serious radio for serious people committed to advancing the national conversation.
The Essentials with Hubert Edwards, Thursday nights live at 6:30 p.m. to 8 p.m. on Guardian Radio 96.9.
This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM. Fresh news, smart talk, all day.
One day, when the glory comes, it will be ours, it will be ours. Oh, one day, when the war is won, we will be sure, we will be sure. Oh, glory, glory, glory. Oh,
good morning. Welcome back. Thank you so much for staying with me. Leyvon Miller on your radio. I got a call. Let's go to the call. Good morning, call. You're on.
Good morning, my good cousin. This is Alfie's Alexander Finlayson.
Hey, Mr. Finlayson. How are you?
Oh, very well. On Monday, I had the opportunity to visit my doctor.
Mm-hmm.
And that is right south of Bamboo Shack.
Mm-hmm.
And right north of where the convent was. And would you believe it? I saw police, I heard shots, and as far as I know, people were killed.
Mm-hmm.
But even if they were not killed, I didn't hear the minister speak about it. He spoke about somebody being killed in, Chippenham.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm wondering why nobody knows about it.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody was there crying and everything else. I can't figure out what happened or what didn't happen.
Mm.
They would have had to go to the hospital, won't they?
Yes, sure.
But there were a lot of police there.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of police. The road was cut off.
Was this on Monday when the man was murdered right up
Monday
on Palima Street?
Yes.
Okay. That was reported in the news, wasn't it?
Oh, was it?
Yes.
At what time was it reported in the news?
I don't know, but I recall hearing it in the news. I don't remember what time it was, but I remember the shooting.
Okay, but I listened to the radio. I was listening to radio in particular for it.
Mm.
And I guess I apologize, but I didn't hear it the way... I didn't hear the minister talking about it
I think... Isn't this the shooting where the woman said, they killed my one son, something to that effect? I think it was in yesterday's paper.
Yeah, I don't know if it's one or two, but I know people were there crying.
Yeah. Yeah, no, that's in the paper yesterday.
in the papers yesterday. I go to Nassau Garden yesterday, so I have to look at
it. I think the headline is, "They killed my one son." I think look for that.
I look at it. I got it last night when I was at the show.
Okay.
Anyhow, thank you ever so much.
All right, Hawk. Good to hear from you.
Well.
Thank you.
Thanks.
325-4259. The text right here says, "Hey, Mr. Miller, the lady calling concerning how the police deal with people with mental issues is correct. The government should establish a special unit manned by mental health professionals. If not already in place, officers should be trained to de-escalate these situations and given non-lethal force." I agree. I believe it is something that we will have to deal with in a developing democracy. I do also agree, though, with the theory that suggests that if I am met with deadly force, I must respond with deadly force. Let's take this call. Good morning, caller.
Hey, Mr. Miller.
Hey, 52.
Yeah, how you doing?
I feel good.
Yeah, you know, the lady had called, you know, I love what she said, great ideas of the last text too. I just wanted to make the even people aware of the nonverbal communication that the government is sending to us about the no love. I was wondering where the human rights was. We are seeing two mentally incapacitated people or unstable people shot right now. The non-verbal message is no love, because by now they should have had dogs and tasers. You know, and not everything is just drink blood, drink blood, drink blood. You feel me?
Mm-hmm.
Have a good day, brother.
Appreciate it. Text right here says, "Good morning, Mr. Miller. We are in another hurricane. Abaco is still not prepared. How is this even possible after the money they spent?" The woman says she praying and hoping. Didn't I just read it for you? Check out the Nassau Guardian this morning. The minister said they sitting at the table, they praying, they hoping, they're hopeful, and they're prayerful. You know, that's the way forward. That is how we're going to get it done. Hi, Leyvon. Hubert Minnis is going to cost those MPs who may be good MPs, but because of his disrespect, discrimination, and bad treatment towards the Bahamian people, they will lose their seats. But are you estimating a landslide, though? Because I don't feel a landslide. I don't feel the tremors of a landslide. And I will say this, in all fairness, I didn't feel the tremors of a landslide with the Free National Movement either. But, we got to the point in our election cycle where they was able to get the chief to come out. And I don't know what it was. Maybe it was cosmosis. Who knows? But the minute it happened, the tide began to rise in the favor of the FNM. So my question is, what are we going to do this time when there is no us, or when there is no sign of the victory, right? Like, can these fellas go out there and on their own steam create a situation where the election is exciting? And I believe that there are a couple exciting seats to watch. 325-4259, you can call me on that. This text right here says, "Hey, Leyvon, I live through Gnap Street, Pinewood Garden. Reuben Raman has no chance. It is a little too late." This one says, I read that already. "Good morning. Sound like you need some morning Cersei." Can I tell you this? This is a confession. Guardian has been doing this thing where they sterilize our studios with antibacterial spray. If you know anything about me, my sinus drips like crazy. So whatever is in this spray usually drives me crazy in the morning times. But I understand that it's for the greater good. And they are wrestling with my sinuses. But I'm perfectly fine in the car on the way here. It's not until I get in studio. So, no, I don't need Soracy. I just need to figure out how to become repellent to this antibacterial spray. That's what's really happening. Let's take a call. Good morning, caller. You're on. Caller, you there? Is it the apocalypse? Hello, caller. Are you there? Nope. Let's read another text message. It says, "Shenandoah trying, but I can't vote for the FNM no more, my brother." That is sad. That is really sad. "Are we going to tell the killers and gangsters not to use lethal force when they are confronted by the police as well?" I don't know. This one says, "Don't blame it on your sinus. Everything is COVID now." No, I don't have COVID. If you know me, if you know me over the years, you will know that I struggle with sinus issues, right? And I'm telling you, everything triggers it. The rain, gas, you know, God help you if I have to sneeze once, because then I can't talk no more for the rest of the day. And I believe it is an attack of the enemy, because I feel like I got things to say, right? And I feel like the devil don't want me to say them. So he continues to try to attack my larynx. Is that what it's called? My larynx? Yeah. And he wants to make sure that I'm not able to come. But I want to tell you, the Bahamian people, that I am here for you. I will speak truth to power on every occasion I get. And if by chance the devil somehow causes my larynx not to work, I will sign language it on your behalf. You see that? That's how much I care about you all. Mr. Miller, this is the problem now. We don't vote for people based on their merit or track record. We vote strictly under the party's colors. Mr. Miller, the guy talking about St. Barnabas talking out his head. The FNM will keep St. Barnabas along with Freetown. The end. I think Freetown is also one of those you got to watch it seats. Like I want to watch what happens in Freetown. Let's take this call. Good morning, caller. You're on.
Morning. Good morning, Mr. Miller.
Hey, Robert.
Now, I call for this, but let me give you some story. Mm-hmm. That the police in the States have a new thing called, it's called police Spider-Man gun. Mm-hmm. It wraps you up in a rope. So if you have time, Google that. Police okay. Spider-Man gun. Mm-hmm. James Lie like to buy new stuff. He should try to try that.
Okay.
Now, we as a country have learned to vote the whole party out. We like to see who is our best prime minister. Remember, Papa was too tough. I got a tyrant. We vote the whole party out.
Mm-hmm.
We're staying building no bridge. So we vote the whole party out. That's like that.
Mm-hmm.
He tell us. This is my last time I can build a bridge. He will fool us and will trick us. Even MPs who won a good seat lost their seat.
Yeah.
Because the Christie did not build the bridge. I stepped down. Now, Minutes, I can't hear what he's doing. He ain't talking to us. The Minutes running wild. Trust me, if they get 3 seats, out west, out east, and on island, that's a good day.
Well, in that case, then it looks like Adrian Gibson may easily be well on his way to becoming leader of the Free National Movement.
Long Island. Mm-hmm. Long Island people do not vote for you. I don't know why.
I'm saying to you, then, if that is the case, it looks like, because I'll tell you this, if Kalani loses the election but wins his seat, I anticipate he will resign that. He's going to be 70 years old. I don't see him coming to Parliament every day for you all to punch him around like that, right?
No. He will come. He will not come because...
I don't think he'll even swear in. I think he will resign immediately.
Because he cannot deal taking a backlash.
Yeah.
He'd be like Papa going back to the house with family, knowing the crap he has done. But he can't go back to the house no more. He know in the last 5 years, why vote his first 10? That you so love? His first 10 was good. But Papa last 5, he did some horrible, wicked things that bound us for 45 years.
I think Bahamian people should have looked a little deeper into the years. Thank you very much, Robert. I get another time. Let me get a couple of these last messages in. It says, how come people always cry when... What does this say? Why don't the public talk when criminals kill? It's like they only want to bash law enforcement. I completely agree. I prefer the police to be doing the killing if you're acting me. Are we going to... I read that already. If you consume dairy products, stop it. That promotes silence. I'm trying. What's happening in Freetown is Mr. James Diagola doing his job, coming from a proud constituent, polling division number 10. The Texas the texter's prediction outcome must be a musty gaudy. We so dumb on the plantation that we bought their explanation of the flu disappearing. All right, last one. It says, I haven't voted for either of the major parties in 10 years. Miss Rowland Seabreeze improved over the years. If anything, I would have voted for her. But since she's gone, no more F&M for me. Anyway, you hear my music. That's my time. I'm Leyvon Miller. Thank you so much for joining me. I was unleashed on your radio. This is Guardian Radio 96.9 FM, the station for fresh news and smart talk. Don't move, they've got the news, it's now.
The movement is a rhythm to us. Freedom is like religion to us. Justice.